हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम इन फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री फर्स्ट। माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर मिसेस उर्मिला रविंद्र गवड़ी, एम्पाम इन क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस एंड लेक्चरर इन केकेवाग इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी चांदोरी। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ एसे, एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 12, टाइटल एसे ऑफ आयोडीन टू डिटरमाइन परसेंट वेट बाय वेट ऑफ आयोडीन इन द गिवन सैंपल ऑफ आयोडीन। Let's start with learning objective, intellectual skill to understand the concept of to identify titrate and titrant in the titration, to understand the concept of factor calculation, to understand the concept of percentage purity, to understand the difference between iodometry and iodometry type of titration. Motor skill to observe the correct meniscus of the solution in the burette and to observe the color change at the end point of the titration. Concept regarding assay of iodine, it is based upon iodometry, redox type of titration in which standard solution of iodine is used. Iodine is slightly soluble in water. It made soluble by adding potassium iodide, which forms polyiodide, that is Ki3. Where free iodine act as oxidizing agent. The solution is titrated against the standard solution of reducing agent, that is sodium thiosulfate, using starch solution as an indicator. The end point is determined by color change from blue to colorless. In iodometry type of titration, liberated iodine is used for the titration. These are the titration which involve the titration of free iodine, means direct titration with standard sodium thiosulfate. Starch solution is used as an indicator to detect the end point of the titration. Starch shows end point depending upon the structural changes. Starch is a polysaccharide which contains beta amylose and amylopectin. Beta amylose, which is straight chain structure, changes spiral from on observation of iodine leading to bluish coloration, which amylopectin, while amylopectin, which is branch chain structure, absorb iodine and to give insoluble complex. Chemical reaction for assay: two molecule of sodium thiosulfate, that is Na2S2O3 plus iodine, that gives Na2S4O4O6 plus two molecule of sodium iodide. Factor each ml of standardized factor for standardization, each ml of 0.1 ml sodium thiosulfate is equivalent to 0.002784 grams of potassium bromate. And factor for SA, each ml of 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate is equivalent to 0.01269 grams of iodine. For the actual procedure, we require apparatus are iodine flask with stopper 25 ml, burette 50 ml, pipette 10 ml and 25 ml, conical flask 250 ml, measuring cylinder 50 ml and beaker 100 ml. Chemicals: potassium bromate, 2 molar acetic acid, potassium iodide, iodine, sodium thiosulfate, starch solution and 2 molar hydrochloric acid. Now for actual procedure, we move towards laboratory.
Hello friends, welcome in pharmaceutical chemistry first. So let's start with assay of iodine. In previous session, we already discussed the principal reaction, then apparatus required for actual practical chemicals. In this session, we are going to deal with procedure. So let's start with procedure for SA. Procedure: standardization of sodium thiosulfate solution 0.1 normal. For that, we have to take 0.2 gram of potassium bromate solution. Solution, we have to prepare out 50 ml of solution. So we already prepared that solution and take 50 ml of solution of potassium bromate, transfer it into conical flask and then add 2 gram of potassium iodine into this conical flask. shake it properly so that potassium iodide is dissolved in the solution of potassium bromide. Now in this solution we have to add 3 ml of 2 molar HCl. Now shake it properly and titrate this solution against sodium thiosulfate solution using starch as an indicator. Start with titration. Titrates again 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate solution. We have to add starch solution as an indicator towards end point, so we get proper end point. Now add 2 to 3 drops of this starch solution which is freshly prepared. And continue titration till the blue color turn into colorless. The blue color changes to white color solution and the reading for standardization of 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate is 24.5. Repeat this procedure for 3 times and calculate the mean for standardization of sodium thiosulfate solution to calculate the molarity of sodium thiosulfate. So let's start with SAPR. For that we have to take weigh accurately 0.2 gram of iodine and transfer it into iodine flask. Then add 0.1 gram of potassium iodide and 2 ml of distilled water. 2 ml of this distilled water and again 1 ml of 2 molar acetic acid. Now shake it properly and dissolve the iodine by shaking and add 50 ml of distilled water. Shake it well and keep inside for 15 minutes. Add 50 ml of water. Shake it properly and keep this solution inside the dark place for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, we have to titrate this solution against 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate. In burette, we already filled with 0.1 molar sodium thiocyanate, and here in the titration, we have to add starch solution as an indicator towards end point of the reaction. So let's start with titration. Now add the starch solution. Shake properly and again titrate with 1 molar sodium thiosulfate solution. continued titration when this blue color completely turns into white color. Now this blue color is completely turned into white color. So endpoint is blue to colorless. And the burette reading for ACE of iodine is 10.5. Repeat this procedure for 3 times and calculate the mean and calculate the percent purity. So let's start with calculation for standardization of 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate. Molarity is equal to weight of sample into 100 into 250 divided by burette reading into molecular weight into 50. Here 250 is a total volume, and from that volume we have to pipette out 50 ml. So it is given in the formula. Put the value into formula 0.2 into 100 into 250 divided by 24.5, because our standardization burette reading 24.5, 24.6, 24.5, and the average is 24.5. So it is equal to 0.146 molar. Means molarity of sodium thiosulfate is found to be 0.146 molar. So let's start with calculation for percent purity. Our formula is each ml of 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate is equivalent to 0.01269 grams of iodine. So SA reading, mean reading 10.5 ml of 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate will give how many grams of iodine? So X is equal to 0.01269 into 10.5 into calculated molarity, that is 0.146 divided by 0.1. 0.1 is the molarity of the sodium thiosulfate, which is equal to 0.19 grams of iodine. Next, 0.2 gram is weight for calculating the percent purity. So 0.2 gram contains 0.01269 into 10.5 into 0.146 divided by 0.1, and this 0.2 is a 0.2, which is weight counted, which is equal to 0.9726 grams of iodine. Then finally we have to calculate percent purity. So 100 grams contains 0.01269 into 10.5 into 0.146 into 100 divided by 0.1 into 0.2. So finally percentage purity is 97.26% weighed by volume of the iodine. So move towards result part. The molarity of sodium thiosulfate was found to be 0.146 molar, and percentage purity of iodine was found to be 97.26% weighed by volume of the iodine. Thank you.